Hello everyone, this course covers complete elementary biology part 1 and this will help students who are appearing for various competitive exams like NEET, AP biology, SAT biology, PRAXIS biology, regent exams and etc. And this will also help students in their academic course class 11th, and in this video we will be discussing biomolecule lipids. We have already discussed biomolecules, basics, and carbohydrate in the previous videos. And if you have any doubts and questions, please comment in the box below. And for more videos on biomolecules, please refer to the series. So let's see what are lipids. Lipids are fatty acid esters of alcohols and related substances. So what do you mean by esters? Esters is a chemical compound that is derived from an acid in which at least one of the hydroxyl group, that is OH group, is replaced by O alkyl group. They are insoluble in water, but they get dissolved in a number of nonpolar organic solvents like ether, benzene, chloroform, acetone, etc. And they form colloidal complex and get dispersed uniformly in water in the form of minute droplets. And the complex is called emulsion. Lipids are basically made up of carbon, hydrogen, and sometimes oxygen, in which the content of oxygen is always small as compared to hydrogen and carbon. Many lipids contain small amount of additional elements like phosphorus, nitrogen, sulfur. The common examples of lipids include butter, ghee, cooking oil, natural rubber, cholesterol, carotene of carrot or lycopene of tomato, eucalyptus oil, menthol, vitamins A, E and K. Now, depending upon their composition and characteristics, lipids are often classified into fats, cutin, suberin, waxes, phospholipids, glycolipids, carotenes, sterols. And the basic component of all lipids are fatty acids. This is important. The basic component of all the lipids are fatty acids. Now, fatty acids are organic compounds having hydrocarbon chains that end in a carboxyl group. So, this is a hydrocarbon chain and this has a carboxyl group at the end. So, carboxyl group is COOH. Hydrocarbon chains may be straight or have a ring structure. Some fatty acid also possesses hydroxyl group, that is OH group, and the length is generally 4 to 24 carbons, and common fatty acids have 16 to 18 carbons. Now plants have biosynthetic machinery to manufacture all types of fatty acids, while in case of animals they also have the machinery, but many animals lack mechanisms to synthesize 3 fatty acids. And what are these? Linoleic, linolenic and arachidonic acids. They are called essential fatty acids or EFA. So they must be present in animal diet. Now essential fatty acids occur in most edible oils like sunflower oil, groundnut, cottonseed, coconut, etc. And the deficiency produces phrenoderma or follicular hyperkeratosis. So these are skin related diseases. Fatty acids are of two main types, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated do not possess double bond in their carbon chains, and the general formula is CnH2NO2. So if we look at the structure, it contains all single bonded carbon atoms, no double bonds. And the common examples of saturated fatty acids are palmitic acid and stearic acid. Let us look at the structure of palmitic acid. It is a straight chain, consists of 16 carbon atoms and 32 hydrogen, 2 oxygen. Oxygen is present in the carboxyl group. It contains a straight chain of single bonded carbon atoms. Next is stearic acid. Carbon atoms are 18 and hydrogen are 36. So it's a straight chain, single bonded carbon atom with no double bonds. So the formula is C18, H36 and O2. Again, oxygen is from the carboxyl group. Now, unsaturated fatty acid possesses one or more double bonds in their carbon chains. Now, they have double bond in their structure. And the general formula is CnH2n minus 2XO2. So, X is the number of double bonds. Let us look at the examples. Oleic acid with one double bond. So the formula is C18H34O2. Linoleic acid, it has two double bonds. Formula is C18H36 minus 2 into 2. So this comes out to be 4 is 32. Next is linolenic acids with three double bonds and arachidonic acid with the four double bonds. So unsaturated fatty acids have lower melting point than the saturated fatty acids. Why? Let us see. Because double bonds cause the hydrocarbon chains to bend. Therefore, the fatty acids cannot compact tightly together. Thus, it reduces the forces of interaction that are van der Waals forces of interaction between the fatty acids. So most plant lipids have unsaturated fatty acids, which are good for our health, while most animal lipids have saturated fatty acids. Unsaturated fatty acids are found in aquatic animals like the oil from the marine fish. They are rich in omega-3 fatty acids, and we all know that omega-3 fatty acids are good for the brain. Now the carboxyl group is a hydrophilic group, that is water loving. Hydro means water, philic means loving. They are also known as polar or water soluble group. So this part of the fatty acid, that is the hydroxyl part, is the water loving part or water soluble part, while the rest of the hydrocarbon chain is nonpolar or lipophilic. Lipo means lipids, philic means loving, which are lipids loving or hydrophobic or water insoluble. Now, polar end sticks to the water. If we look at this structure, this is the polar head of the lipid that has the COOH group, hydroxyl group, which is water loving group, so that fatty acids form a monolayer over it. The water soluble end of the fatty acid also reduces surface tension, and it increases the wetting or the cleaning power of water. And this is utilized in soap action and is actually the action of fatty acids that are contained in the soap. Let us look at the diagram. For example, this is a skin and it has a lot of dirt and bacteria on it. With the help of soap that has the nonpolar end and the polar end, nonpolar end will stick to the dirt while the polar end is hydrophilic. So with the help of water, it will remove the dirt from the skin. So let us quickly go through the differences, as we have already discussed about the saturated fats and unsaturated fats. So saturated do not possess double bonds, and unsaturated one or more double bonds. All carbon atoms are fully saturated. They are unsaturated. They have straight chains saturated, while in case of unsaturated, the chains bend at the double bond. They are solid at room temperature in case of saturated fats, while unsaturated fats are liquid at ordinary temperature. Saturated fats have higher melting point, while unsaturated fats have lower melting point because of the bends in the structure. Animal fats are mostly saturated fats. Plant fats are generally unsaturated. Saturated fats increases blood cholesterol. Unsaturated fats lower blood cholesterol. Hydrogenation has no effect on saturation. Hydrogenation means the conversion of double bonds to single bond with the help of hydrogen. And hydrogenation in case of unsaturated fats converts unsaturated fats into saturated. In case of saturated, essential fatty acids are absent, and in case of unsaturated, essential fatty acids are present. Saturated fats are not much affected by the exposure to air, while in case of unsaturated, on exposure to air, they tend to solidify. Now let us look at the classification of lipids. Lipids can be distinguished into three types: simple, compound, and derived. Simple lipids are formed from fatty acids and alcohol. They do not have any additional group, and the examples are fats, suberin, cutin, and wax. Compound or conjugated lipids possesses additional groups beside fatty acids and alcohol. And the examples include phospholipids, glycolipids, lipoproteins. In lipoproteins, lipids are linked to proteins. And derived lipids are either lipid-like chemicals, for example, sterols, or they are derived from the lipids, such as terpenes, prostaglandins. Now let us look at the true fats or the neutral fats. They are triglycerides. Now these are formed by esterification of three molecules of fatty acids with one molecule of trihydric alcohol glycerol, and three molecules of water are eliminated. 1, 2, and 3. The word triglyceride, it refers to the number of three molecule of fatty acids esterified to a molecule of a glycerol. If the number of fatty acids attached to the glycerol, it happens to be 2. The ester is known as diglyceride or monoglyceride if there is only one molecule of fatty acid attached to the glycerol molecule. In fats, three fatty acids are only rarely similar. For example, in tripalmitin, tristearine, and trioline. In this case, all the three fatty acids are similar. They are called pure fats. Usually they are dissimilar, or two of the three fatty acids are similar, and they are called mixed fats. And the example is butter. For example, here R1, R2, R3, they are three different fatty acids. And after esterification, three molecules of water are released. Fats are named after the names of fatty acid. For example, dipalmitostearin. Palmitooleostearine, that is R1, R2, R3, and stearooleopalmitin. So most neutral fats are a mixture of different, they are a mixture of different glycerides, triglycerides. But for the commercial use, fats are differentiated into hard fats and oils. Oils are those fats which are liquid at room temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. This is because they have a low melting point, as we already studied their structure, why they have a low melting point. And the examples include groundnut, rapeseed oil, mustard oil, sesame oil, sunflower oil, safflower oil, etc. The low melting property is actually the property of a fatty acid. Oils are richer in either unsaturated fatty acids or fatty acids having small carbon chain. Unsaturated fatty acids can combine with oxygen and other chemicals. Therefore, exposed oils, they have a tendency to solidify. So these oils get solidified when they are exposed to oxygen. Hence, they are known as drying oils. Edible oils can be converted into hard fats through the process of hydrogenation. So in hydrogenation, unsaturated fatty acids having double bonds are changed to saturated state, having all single bonded carbon atoms. You can see here, hydrogen gas is added under pressure. And the common examples include vanaspati or vegetable ghee, for example dalda or margarine. They are obtained from oils through hydrogenations, and these are generally not good for health. Oils with polyunsaturated fatty acids, that is fatty acids with more than one double bond, are called polyunsaturates or PUFA. Polyunsaturated fatty acids. They are recommended by physicians to persons having hypertension, high blood cholesterol, and other cardiovascular diseases. It is because polyunsaturated fatty acid lower blood pressure. That's very important. That's why they are very good for health. Now, edible oils having polyunsaturated fatty acids are safflower and sunflower oils. Hard fats are solid at room temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. They contain long chain saturated fatty acids. And the example is animal fat. Now, butter is soft because it contains good quantity of short chain fatty acid. Next comes waxes. They are fatty acid esters of long chain monohydric alcohols like cytyl, saryl, maraceyl. Other fat like substances are also occur in waxes. Plant wax occur in cuticle along with cutin, and as grayish waxy coating or bloom around the plant organs. Wax found on the upper surface of floating leaves prevent wetting and submergence. So the leaves which are floating, they have a layer of wax on it, which prevents it from wetting and submergence. Wax found on the surface of land plants is useful in reducing transpiration, that is the prevention of loss of water from the plant. In animal, cutaneous glands are known to secrete a wax known as lanolin for forming a protective water insoluble coating on animal fur. So this wax act as a water insoluble coat. Cerumen or ear wax is secreted by cutaneous gland for lubricating eardrum. Bees build their hives from wax that are secreted by their abdominal gland. So this is an important question. You might have it in your competitive exams that wax in bees is secreted by the abdominal glands. Bees is a complex of several waxes. And the major component is ester of palmitic acid and maricyl alcohol. And second major component is the ester of palmitic acid with hexacosanol. Now, tuberculosis and leprosy bacteria produce a wax known as wax D, which is a major factor in their pathogenicity. Paraffin wax is obtained from petroleum. Candles are made of paraffin and stearic acid. Waxes are used in cosmetics and polishes. Wax paper is used for wrapping. So these are various uses where wax can be used. Cutin is a complex lipid that is produced by the cross esterification and polymerization of hydroxy fatty acids as well as other fatty acids with or without esterification by alcohols other than glycerol. This is important. So in case of glycerol, there are other alcohols. Cutin occurs in the aerial epidermal cell walls as well as a separate layer of cuticle on the outside of the epidermal cell. Cuticle has 50 to 90% of cutin. Cutin reduces the rate of transpiration and it also binds epidermal cell. So these are the functions of cutin. Suberin is a mixture of fatty material having a condensation products of glycerol and phenolic acid. So you just have to learn what suberin is made of. Suberin makes the cell wall strong and impermeable. It occurs in the walls of Koch cells and endodermal cells. Next is phospholipids. This is a common membrane lipid. They are triglyceride lipids where one fatty acid is replaced by phosphoric acid, which is often linked to the additional nitrogenous groups like choline, serine, inositol, etc. Now, look at the structure. So, in this, a fatty acid is replaced by a phosphoric acid and which is linked to choline. Now, phospholipids are amphipathic. So, what do you mean by amphipathic? That is, they carry both hydrophilic polar and hydrophobic nonpolar groups. So, this is the hydrophilic head that has the phosphoric acid or the phosphate, and this is the hydrophobic tail that has the saturated fatty acid and unsaturated fatty acid. The hydrocarbon chains of two fatty acids function as hydrophobic nonpolar tails of the phospholipid molecule. The phosphate and additional nitrogenous group behave as a hydrophilic head. In the aqueous medium, the phospholipid molecules arrange themselves to form a bilayer or double layer. The polar heads or hydrophilic heads of molecule, they form the two surfaces which are in contact with the water. So these are the polar heads in contact with water. This is the other polar head in contact with the water. The hydrophobic or nonpolar tails of phospholipid molecules are towards the center. So these are the hydrophobic tails or the nonpolar tails. Lipid bilayer is the basic component of all cell membrane. Sphingolipids are the lipids having amino alcohol sphingosine. Now, sphingomyelin contain an additional phosphate group. Look at the structure. It contains the additional phosphate group attached to choline, like phospholipids. They occur in the myelin sheath of the nerve. So this is the myelin sheath. So sphingolipids or sphingomyelin is present in the myelin sheath of the nerves. Now, cerebroside possesses sugar residue, galactose. So this is the structure of cerebroside. It has this sugar residue, galactoside. They occur in the nerve membranes. Gangliosides possesses sugar residue. We just have to learn what are these four sugar residues: glucose, galactose, sialic acid, and acetylglucosamine. They influence ion transport. So their function is in the ion transport through the membrane. Transport through the membrane, as well as they function as a receptor of viral particles. Gangliosides occur in the gray matter of the brain, and excessive accumulation of gangliosides produces a disorder known as Tay-Sachs disease. So both cerebrosides and gangliosides, they both contain sugar residue. They contain sugar residue. So they are known as glycolipids. Next come lipoproteins. As the name indicates, they are composed of lipids and proteins. They are present in blood, milk, and egg yolk. Next comes terpenes. Now they are lipid like hydrocarbons. They are formed of isoprene units. Now you have to remember the monomer or the component of terpenes. Now steroids like cholesterols are also derived from terpenes having 6 isoprene units. Essential oils of plant origins are terpenes with 2 to 4 isoprene units. An example are camphor, menthol. These are all essential oils and they contain terpenes. Gibberellins are a group of plant growth hormone with 4 isoprene units. An equal number of isoprene units occur in vitamins A, E, and K. Phytol, or the tail of chlorophyll A. So the tail of chlorophyll A molecule is a terpene with the 4 isoprene units. Carotenoids, which is made up of carotenes and xanthophylls, have 8 isoprene units. Natural and synthetic rubbers are terpenes with thousands of isoprene units. They are arranged in a linear fashion. So isoprene units are arranged in a linear fashion in natural and synthetic rubbers. Prostaglandins are the derivative of arachidonic acid and 20 carbon fatty acids. What are their functions? Functions of prostaglandins include vasodilation, that means widening of the blood vessels, vasoconstriction, bronchoconstriction, acid production in stomach, cell communication, hormone modulation. Next comes steroids. They are the group of complex lipids that possesses hydrogenated cyclopentano perhydrophenanthrene ring structure. So this is the ring structure of a steroid. Position of carbon atoms are numbered. Attached to carbon atom 10 and 13 are present methyl group. 10 and 13 are present methyl group, that is CH3 group. Having the carbon atoms 19 and 18 respectively. In cholesterol, a side chain is attached to carbon 17. So in case of cholesterol, a side chain is attached to this carbon atom. Sterols have one or more hydroxyl groups. And in case of sterols, we have hydroxyl groups. Others have carbonyl or carboxyl groups. Now, look at the structure of sterols. So, they contain 8 to 10 carbon long aliphatic side chain at carbon 17. So, this is carbon 17. It has this long aliphatic side chain. And the examples include cholesterol, ergosterol, coprosterol, etc. Bile acids are the steroid carboxylic acid derived from cholesterol. So these are the derivatives of cholesterols, and the examples are glycocholic acid and taurocholic acid. Gonadal sex hormone includes estradiol, estrogen, testosterone, progesterone, while adrenocortical hormones include corticosterone. Cardiac glycosides, they contain unsaturated lactone ring structure at carbon number 17. So they have an unsaturated lactone ring structure, and the example is digitoxin. Next comes saponins. They are glycoside having steroids which form foam when their watery solution is shaken, and they are widely distributed in plants. They can dissolve RBCs even in high dilution. Next are the anabolic steroids. They are synthetic derivatives of testosterone, which is a male sex hormone, which are used clinically in promoting growth and repair of body tissues in senile and debilitating illness. Toad poison and other carcinogenic hydrocarbons are also steroid in nature. So these were all steroids. Now let's move to cholesterol. Now, cholesterol is a common sterol that is found in many animals, human beings, and some plants. For example, potato or solanum tuberosum, which is a scientific name for potato. And where it is manufactured? In the liver, as well as we get it from outside. So, cholesterol occurs in free form and in the combined form, where it is esterified with the fatty acid. Let us look at the structure of the cholesterol. This is the free form, and this is the carbon number 17 that has a unsaturated long aliphatic chain, and carbon number 3 has a hydroxyl group. Carbon number 10 and 13 has a methyl group, that is CH3, which forms the carbon number 19 and 18. Cholesterol and its esters are insoluble in water. When cholesterol level rises in the blood, it tends to be deposited in the artery. So these are the blood arteries. When its level increases, it gets deposited, and the condition arises which is known as arteriosclerosis. Arteriosclerosis, and it leads to high blood pressure, high BP, and many other heart diseases. Crystallization inside the gallbladder leads to the formation of gallbladder stone. So ultimately, its accumulation can also lead to the formation of stones in the gallbladder. So what are the functions? We'll quickly go through the functions of steroid. Cholesterol, we all know that it is a precursor of the steroid hormones, various hormones, sex hormone, adrenal cortex hormones. Steroid hormones, they control sex expression, sexual cycle, allergies, differentiation, body fluids. Cholesterol form vitamin D on exposure to UV rays, ultraviolet radiations. Cholesterol is useful in the absorption of fatty acids. So these are various functions of cholesterol. Cholesterol is involved in the formation of vitamin D. It is very important for the absorption of fatty acids. And steroid diosgenin is obtained from Dioscorea, that is yam. It has anti-fertility property. Anabolic steroids are used mainly in debilitating disorders, in correcting these diseases. And sometimes they are misused by bodybuilders or players. Sterols are known to be essential for plant growth, induction of flowering, expression of sex in some plants. So these are the important functions of sterols. Cholesterol is a constituent of animal cell membrane. We already talked about it. And cholesterol helps in forming bile salts. Cardiac glycosides, they tone up cardiac muscles, as the name indicates, and correct arrhythmia. Birth control pills have steroid hormone progesterone, with or without oestrogen. So birth control pills are also made of steroid hormone. Now, functions of lipids. Fats serve as a food reserve. In case of hibernating animals, they store extra fat prior to the onset of winter, and in case of migratory, they do the same before migration. And they also function as concentrated food, because as compared to carbohydrates, when they yield more than twice as much energy per unit weight. So when compared to carbohydrates and lipids, the energy yield is more in case of lipids. Fats can be converted to carbohydrates. Therefore, fats stored in oil seeds like groundnut, mustard, not only provide energy, but they provide raw material for the growth of embryo. In seeds and spores, lipids help in thermal insulation, protection from UV radiation, and loss of water. They have a covering to protect the loss of water. Vitamins A, D, E, K are soluble in fats. The latter not only act as carriers, but also protect them from oxidation. So these are the functions of lipids. Next we have, in animal fat occurs droplets inside the cells known as adipocytes. So what are adipocytes? Adipocytes of cold-blooded animal or poikilothermic animals, they have higher amount of unsaturated fatty acid compared to the warm-blooded animals. Fatty or adipose tissue forms insulating layer below the skin of animals for protection against low temperature. Whale has a very thick layer of subcutaneous fat known as blubber, and animals of caudal regions, they have a thick fatty layer for insulation, for example in case of polar bear. Subcutaneous fat rounds off the body contours of animals and human beings. In animals, the fats produces shock absorbing cushion around the eyeball, gonads, kidneys, and other vital organs. Edible oils, the oils which we use for cooking purposes, and animal fats, they are present in milk, they yield butter and ghee. Plant oils are used as a low cholesterol fat, which are good for health, and they are also hydrogenated to form vegetable ghee, which are not healthy. Soap are previously manufactured from animal fat. Nowadays, plant fats are used for this purpose. Drying oil having unsaturated fatty acids are used in paint industry. Waxes form a protective layer over the animal fur. They protect the floating leaves of aquatic plants from wetting and submergence. And in case of land plants, they reduce the rate of transpiration. Myelin sheath around the nerve fiber take part in the insulation. Phospholipids, glycolipids, and sterols are components of cell membranes. So these are three important things: phospholipids, glycolipids, and sterols. Fragrance of many plant products is due to the fat-like substances, terpenes. In birds, oil from preen glands is used to lubricate feathers and protect them from wetting. Hair are similarly lubricated in animal skin, mammalian skin. It prevents their felting. The skin is also protected from drying up. In desert animal, they employ fat as a source of metabolic water. So this is very important. They employ fat as a source of water. For example, kangaroo rat, camel. Kangaroo rat does not drink water. And camel uses fat that is stored in the hump for obtaining metabolic water during extreme desiccating conditions, extreme dry conditions. So this was all about lipids. I hope you liked the video. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos.